Jonathan.
Good, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, buddy.
So where are you going today?
I think we'll head to the bar, if that's okay.
Bar. Perfect, I got the nice one for you.
Awesome. Welcome to Translogic. I'm Jonathan Buckley. Public transport is something that most people just take for granted or ignore altogether. But in Detroit, it's a much needed service. That's why one man has stepped up to the plate when he realized that some of the city's transportation needs were not being met. Enter the Detroit Bus Company. Andy Didorosi is the president and founder of Detroit Bus Company. Where did this idea come from?
I was working in asset liquidation, found some buses for sale, and I said, these things are awesome. The light rail system was about to be made, and then it fell apart. So I said, let's just replace that service. Let's just do what they were doing, you know? And so we just put buses on the road and hoped that people would hop on, and it actually worked.
So it was just for the public? I mean, was there a certain sector of people that you were looking to help get around, or?
We wanted to find a problem that was big enough to matter if we solved it, but small enough that we could actually tackle it.
Yep.
And so the service that we offered was just Fridays and Saturdays. It was from the suburbs into the city, and then we had a circulator around inside of the city. So people could come down, see what Detroit's about, go out for the night, and get back. You know, drunk driving is actually a huge problem in the city because people just think, I'm not gonna get caught. You know, why not? And so this bus service really provided a way for people to go out and do everything without a car for once in the city, which you haven't been able to do in 40 years. Then we got approached by the Skillman Foundation to start our Youth Transit Alliance, and we rolled into that.
So now you're actually driving for the public schools in Detroit, don't you?
Yeah, and we're getting kids in Southwest Detroit from their schools to their after-school programs and home, so they can get access to all these great resources that are out there, but they just need a ride.
Right, okay. Who's worse, the school kids or the drunks?
Drunks by far.
Really?
Drunks by far, yeah.
I've been driving since December 2012, so about coming up on 2 years now.
How you like it so far?
It's fun, man. I like it. I get to do a lot of cool things. Get to go to different places, meet a lot of interesting people, so it's fun.
The bus system has never been great in the city of Detroit, but recently a lot of lines have been cut. A lot of neighborhoods just straight up don't have any bus transportation. And if you're relying on that for your livelihood, that's it. I mean, you're out of a job.
That's the part that hasn't been done, you know, going directly to a child's house to pick them up, to pick up their sisters, to pick up their brothers, to pick up, you know, sometimes their parents even ride the bus with us.
Yeah.
So, and then we pick them up, we door to door, we pick them up at the house, and then at the end of the day, after they're done with their particular program, we drop them right back off at home.
When it comes to GPS, you guys are employing this technology on the buses as well, aren't you? So parents can figure out exactly where the kids are at any given time.
Yeah, every bus is GPS tracked, and we share the location with the parents, the students, the programs, the schools. Everybody knows where the buses are. And we actually have each bus doing the work of roughly four buses because of the software that we use that dynamically runs around the neighborhood based on demand. I really think that dollars go a lot further when it's put towards a smart system like this.
Mm. When it comes to the powertrains on the buses, you guys have employed biofuels?
Yeah, so we run a soy-based biodiesel, which we didn't have to modify the buses at all, but we have to adjust the mix based on the temperature. It's more costly, it's a little bit arduous, but it really makes a difference. And the buses smell like fried food going down the road, which is really weird. It's really weird.
You seem like a pretty cool bus driver compared to the bus drivers I had when I was a kid. Do you ever have to get strict?
Sometimes, you know, if they get out of hand, but you know, we give them the rules of the bus, you know, the do's and the don'ts. Of course, you want everyone to have fun.
Give us your best. Sit down back there.
Hey, yo, sit down. See that face?
Yeah, that's serious face. Well, it all started in 2011 when you bought your very first bus.
Yep.
It's grown to quite a sizable fleet now, hasn't it?
Yeah, we're at 8 buses now, and we've got everything from school buses, transit buses, the big motor coaches.
Right, well, we've got 4 buses behind us right now.
Yep.
Silver Bullet,
yep.
The Betis, the Loch Ness.
Yep.
And what's the fourth one?
Oh, that's Gordy, named after Barry Gordy at Motown. Yeah.
Is there a in-house artist that takes care of the beautifying of the buses?
Each bus actually has a different artist, which is pretty cool. And so we put out a call for artists, they submit some drawings, and we put, these are all local Detroit artists that have done these buses.
Yep. What's the demand like nowadays? Is it a full bus sort of situation? Do you have a lot of patrons?
Oh yeah, the bus is full and the demand is high. The demand is so high that sometimes we have to turn away certain people because, you know, there's a waiting list.
What about the city? Are they on board with you guys? Because sometimes you can get a little bit of resistance from them.
You'd be surprised. They're actually really in support of it. When I launched the company, we got the Spirit of Detroit Award from City Council. Yep. We worked with the Detroit Department of Transportation. They've been supportive of it, mostly because they've got all other sorts of things to solve. So they don't have the time to bother with us. And I think that we are working alongside them. We're really not competitive with the public system. So we're just trying to fill transit gaps. We're not trying to replace anybody. We're just interested in any way that we can make an impact with the skills that we've got. So if that's tech, if that's community building, if that's buses on the road, you know, we really want to find a way to make the greatest impact with the small resources that we got.
Well, from drunken bar patrons to school children, they've got a very diverse client base. Detroit Buses, they're serving their community with purpose and with style. And by using old recycled buses and biofuels, they're also serving the environment. It's a great idea. For Translogic, I'm Jonathan Buckley. We'll catch you next time.